Hello and welcome to Awaaz The Voice. I am Nazir Ganai. Today a very special and unique art exhibition was held in Arts Emporium in Srinagar with panelists highlighting the importance of epigraphy. Kashmir region has a history of its cultural legacy and the panelists highlighted how it is important to restore this cultural legacy. This staging of inscriptions on the buildings like khanqahs, mosques, shrines, mausolea, temples, gardens and similar public spaces may be understood as a well-thought and strategic introduction and circulation of a linguistic script, style and content that gradually contributed to the creation of a unique, personate, habitus and cultural landscape in the Valley of Kashmir. In case of major Sufi khanqahs in the region, the panelists said that they find the calligraphy was employed extensively in a complex program of textual ornamentation drawing from Quranic verses, prophetic sayings, as well as devotional poetry, establishing the spiritual status of various Sufi orders. Many of these specimens of public text from Shahmiri, Mughal, Afghan rule, Kashmir have been lost to the vestiges of time. Reuse of buildings, material, destruction in the fire-related disasters, or simply by force of weathering. This exhibition highlights some of the sites covered under the project, including documentations, translation, photographs related to the drawings.
So basically, there is this verse of Iqbal, if I remember it correctly, it's in Persian, which says, "Hifz kun tarikh ra pain da shu," which is roughly, you could translate that, document your past if you want to live forever. And that is what our understanding and our work in Kashmir has been, that people should become aware of the past, they should understand their past to understand who they are. So basically, the event is about historical texts that you find in buildings, any building. It can be a religious building like a khanqah, a mosque, a temple, a gurdwara. It can be a public building like a bridge. It can be a civic building. It can be a garden. So from 14th century to 19th century, what were the texts that were written on these historical sites? What do they speak about the period and how do they make us understand the socio-cultural significance of those periods?
जब 2021 में श्रीनगर को यूनेस्को क्रिएटिव सिटी फॉर क्राफ्ट का दर्जा मिला, तो तब से लेके हमने, चाहे वो क्राफ्ट टूर हो या जो हमने प्रोग्राम चलाया नो योर आर्टिज़न, जिसमें हमने उन आर्टिज़न्स को जिनको शायद लोग जानते नहीं थे उनको प्लेटफॉर्म दिया ताकि उनकी जो उनके जो फन पारे हैं उनको लोग देखें और आर्टिज़न्स पे फोकस हो. उसी सिलसिले को आगे बढ़ाते हुए हमने जो हिस्टोरिकल पर्सपेक्टिव है हमारे क्राफ्ट का, जिस पे कैलीग्राफी बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट जाविया है, तो उसको हिस्टोरिकली कैसे इवॉल्व हुआ और कौन सी लैंग्वेजेस यूज़ की गई, ये जानना बहुत ज़रूरी है. कि जब भी आज के डेट में भी जब भी कोई बिल्डिंग बनती है, इनॉग्रेशन फाउंडेशन स्टोन हम डालते हैं. इसी तरह जो है पास्ट में भी एक कम्यूमरेटिव स्टोन होता था या फाउंडेशन स्टोन ले किया जाता था, जिससे आपको इस बिल्डिंग के बारे में या हिस्ट्री के बारे में बहुत सारी जानकारी मिलती थी. अब ये जो है समीर और उसके टीम ने जगह जगह जाके इन स्टोन्स को जो है पहले डॉक्यूमेंट किया, फोटोग्राफ किया, फिर इनका ट्रांसलेशन किया और एक जगह प्रेजेंट किया. चाहे उसमें हमारे जो है मुगल गार्डन्स है, फिर हमारे वेरिना का स्प्रिंग है, फिर हमारे जो ब्रिजेस है, फिर हमारे जो टेंपल्स हैं, श्राइन्स हैं, तो इन सब जो डाइवर्सिटी है यहाँ हेरिटेज की, उसको यहाँ एग्जिबिट किया गया ताकि लोग जो है अपने जगह को जानने का शायद ये बेहतरीन मौका है. एक हिस्टोरिकल पर्सपेक्टिव आपको मिलता है और आने वाले दिनों में ये जो है हेरिटेज या क्राफ्ट को प्रमोट करना बहुत ज़रूरी है, क्योंकि यूजुअली हमने कश्मीर को एक फिज़िकल डेस्टिनेशन के तौर पे प्रमोट किया है, लेकिन क्राफ्ट को हमने जो है प्रमोट नहीं किया है. और क्राफ्ट की वसादत से, हेरिटेज की वसादत से और टूरिज्म की वसादत से लोग यहाँ आएंगे और उनका जो है एवरेज स्टे बढ़ेगा, क्योंकि यहाँ बहुत कुछ है देखने के लिए. तो इसी सिलसिले में हमने ये एक छोटी सी एग्जीबिशन की थी जो है एक हफ्ते की है, जिसमें इस्तेदा है लोगों से कि वो यहाँ आए और यहाँ पे जो पैनल्स हैं उनको देखें, फिर उनकी हिस्ट्री जान सकते हैं. तो एक अच्छा लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंस है.
बट आई फील दैट यू नो एज एन एकेडमिक इट इज़ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर द यू नो एकेडमिक लीडर्स. आई थिंक दे हैव टू टेक द लीड इन प्रमोटिंग अवेयरनेस, प्रमोटिंग नॉलेज जनरेशन, प्रमोटिंग रिसर्च इन areas related to different aspects of our heritage. I'm sure it is documented, but you will also agree with me that a lot of it has been degraded, defaced, and we are losing it. So it is very important that every center of excellence, academic institute, should have a special focus on how to preserve our culture, how to preserve our language, how to preserve our heritage, including all types of heritage. This may be a small but very important part of our heritage today, what we have seen. Very small but very important. But if you look at the total heritage of Jammu Kashmir, I think it is huge, and I as an academic feel that it is not well documented.
Well, it's very, this event is, it talks about epigraphy of mostly which is on the shrines of Srinagar mostly. So it's a very, because we don't know, a lot of the times we have a lot of reverence with these shrines, but unfortunately we don't know the historical background of it. So this gives a good historical background ki ye shrines kab bani hai, kisne banayi hai, kon architect tha, architect se, you know, architectural background kya hai in cheezon ka. So ye is cheez se ye hamare jo mere jaise log hai jinko bahut reverence hai in shrines ke sath, ye bahut important aspect ban jata hai. If we find something more, something along the lines which basically helps me in sort of promoting the craft of Kashmir, yes, absolutely, we would go ahead and do more such events. I think the handicraft sector has seen a robust revival in last 3-4 years, mainly because A, there's a lot of tourism, B, also handicraft department itself has been working very hard on getting the GI marks. On pashmina shawls, carpets, paper mache, so that people can buy genuine handcrafted products as opposed to fakes and things that may not be so genuine and they're not made by hand.